Have you ever looked at the Wikipedia page for a terrestrial planet and thought, man, I wish I knew this much about my fictional terrestrial planet. Why am I even asking? Of course you have, let's do this. YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. Okay, so let's build some habitable, Earth-like terrestrial planets. As always, we're going to need the planet maker equation and this graph. Oh, and we're going to need some ranges for gravity, mass, and radius that will ensure our planet is in fact habitable. To be clear, I mean habitable in relation to physical characteristics. That is, we are going to need to ensure that our planet features active plate tectonics, has the ability to hold on to a suitable atmosphere, and possesses a magnetic field. The ranges for gravity, mass, and radius we use must ensure the presence of these various components. With this in mind, Stephen Dole, in his 1964 work Habitable Planets for Man, sets the ranges for habitable Earth-like planets at 0.4 to 2.3 Earth masses, 0.78 to 1.25 Earth radii, and a surface gravity at 0.68 to 1.5 times the gravity of Earth. These values are fine, but in light of our current scientific understanding, they are a bit conservative. Current research gives us something more like 0.1 to 3.5 Earth masses, 0.5 to 1.5 Earth radii, and a gravity range of about 0.4 to 1.6. So on our graph here, we can discard everything above 3.5 Earth masses and 1.5 Earth radii, leaving us with this window of creative opportunity. Got it? Cool. Let's build. Let's go with a mass of 2 Earth masses and a radius of 1.25. Before we solve for gravity and density, let's graph those mass and radius values. Alrighty then, we are in the red band, which indicates our planet will be composed of iron and silicates, which is exactly what we want. One almighty number crunch later and out pops a high G planet, 25% bigger than Earth, with twice the mass but with a density comparable to Earth. So here's Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, and here, to scale, is our planet. Our friendly neighborhood super Earth, eh? Now for something a little smaller. How about one third the mass of Earth and just over half the radius of Earth? Again, check the graph to see if we're in the red zone, and we are. Run the numbers through the planet maker equation and we get these values. What should immediately stick out is that the density of our little rock here is relatively speaking quite high. Such high densities indicate that we are dealing with a supermercury, a world whose volume is dominated by a large iron core. Again, here's Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars, and here's our little supermercury. But hey, what if you don't want a rocky terrestrial planet? Maybe you want an ocean planet. All water, no land, let's do this. Just like with our standard rocky planet, we have to stick to our ranges for gravity, mass, and radius. But in the case of a water world, we want to be in the blue band here. Here lie the planets whose overall mass contains a large fraction of water. So let's place our world here, which gives us a mass of 0.4 and a radius of about 0.85-ish. Plug the values into the equation and we get a low density, low G world. Those characteristics in and of themselves scream ocean planet. Furthermore, that dotted line on the graph indicates a world with 25% water, a 52.5% silicate shell, and a 22.5% iron core. Links in the doobly-doo. As always, we can flesh out the details of our world even further by calculating escape velocity, circumference, surface area, and volume, using the same equations from the previous two videos. So there you have it, how to build rocky, watery, super mercury kind of terrestrial planets. Physical characteristics of the various planetary types? Done. Next up, orbital characteristics. Stay tuned. Guys, if you like what you see here in Artifexian, click the links in the description to find me on Facebook and Twitter. And if you're interested, hit like and subscribe for more awesome science-based world building. Thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.